Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So recently I've been working on the air conditioning on my IS300. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to properly flush your system out using this solvent-based AC flush and this flush tool that I borrowed from AutoZone. So stay tuned. The next thing we're gonna go ahead and do is flush out the system. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna remove the rest of this butyl rubber. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take this Allen key out and take the spring and take everything out and go ahead and drill that hole through so that way I could put this back in and just flush it through. All right, we took that thing out, basically the spring and a little cap right there that holds it in there. And then basically you see the inside of that and that pin right there. So we'll go ahead and go drill that out now to make the hole bigger. We were able to clean that thing out. I blew it out with compressed air, cleaned it with some brake clean, just to make sure I get all the burrs and the metal out. So this thing's ready to go back in just for the flush, so we can flush right through this thing and get all the fluid through both sides of this so we clean this baby out. All right, I put the old one back in there for the flush. Remember, when you guys put the new one back together, make sure you clean all that old butyl rubber, especially around the mating surfaces. You don't want any of that getting into the tube and all that place and getting lodged inside your evaporator or anywhere else. So you wanna make sure that's all cleaned out before you screw it in, just to make sure, because a lot of those bits kind of start breaking off. So you gotta be careful with that, but just make sure you clean all that off. So the next step is I'm gonna go ahead and remove the Schrader valves out of here and out of the other one. I'm gonna actually send it through this valve right here. And then the other side, I'm gonna flush it out from that end. And then I'm gonna do a reverse flush also from the back way. There is one hose that's right here, this hose into the compressor and into the condenser that you can actually just take off and clean that thing off the car separately. So I can just basically flush that into a bucket and not worry about it. But the rest of it going into the evaporator, into the car and back out, I'm gonna have to do starting from here and then from the other end. We got the Schrader valves taken out of the both lines. I actually took apart that bottom line there. I tied that line to that spot so that way when I flush it, it goes straight into that bucket I put down there. So now I'm ready to go ahead and flush it. Before I do flush it, I'm just gonna run some compressed air through this thing just to clear out the line of any oils or anything else that's in the line. Once it clears out, then we go ahead and get the flush in there. Take this thing apart. I've got my compressed air. I'm gonna go ahead and send the compressed air. I wanna plug the hole down here because it's open over here, and I'm gonna send it the other direction into the evaporator. So you can hear the air go through. Right now, there's no. I'm just seeing some vapors come through there. So not much, it's probably just some residual oil in there. I'll go ahead, go right down here so I don't have to plug the hole and go straight into this line. You can see just some oil went into the bucket there, but that's about it. So there wasn't really much in here, no gunk, no oil, no dye or anything, which is a good sign actually that we don't have any of that. So we'll go ahead and flush it through with the solvent now. For that condenser side, instead of holding it with my thumb, I went ahead and found a little red cap right there that I put on it. I still have to hold it just to make sure the air doesn't blow it out, but at least it provides a good seal right there. And I can just go ahead and just flush it. So for the AC flush we're gonna use today, we're gonna use this super cool solvent base. I got this at AutoZone. I think AutoZone is one of the few places that sells it. It's 40 bucks for this gallon. You're gonna need to do maybe like 3 flushes. I'm gonna do flush one direction, flush back the other direction, and then one more just to make sure everything's cleared out and clean. And then after that, I'm gonna run compressed air through again just to make sure we get everything out of there. But I borrowed this from AutoZone also. It's one of those free rentals. It was actually a brand new bottle. bottle, so this is gonna work well. It came with everything except for this right here. I had to add this nipple for my air compressor, but aside from that, it pretty much comes with that thing. This, I'm gonna actually use the adapter from my refrigeration kit right here to just clamp it straight to the actual hose and then have it right to the high pressure line and the low pressure line, because this thing actually screws right into that end right there perfectly. So we'll go ahead and do that right now.
A separate line I had there, I went ahead and filled it up with some solvent, put some caps on the end of it, and just let it sit for a little bit to let it dissolve, and then I'll blow that thing out and clean it up. Make sure this thing's open, which it is. It's tight. Make sure that thing's good down there. Go ahead to get the air out. Connect to this guy for now. And then, so right there we have that. Got everything ready. Make sure you have safety glasses on. That's tight. Hold that thing. And then we'll just pulsate it. You can hear it go through. That's nasty, the spray that came out of there. It's all over my floor now, so let me go take care of that on the floor. I didn't think it was gonna spill that badly, but it's flushing everywhere, so let me just take care of that. All right, that solvent kind of stinks, but it does evaporate really quick. Most of that was just kind of a mixture of the oil and the solvent. So we'll go ahead and just get this back in there. Try this again. We'll do it slower this time. That way we don't rush it too much and spray it everywhere again. I'm gonna stand closer down here, put the bucket closer, that way it sprays less. Thank you. pretty much emptied that flush. I'm just letting it just air out now. All right, I figured out a way to make it a little bit cleaner for the reverse flush going the other direction. I actually grabbed this hose off one of my other gauges. I clamped it over here on this side. I'm gonna leave that red plug I had down there. I'm gonna go ahead and put one of those wedge plugs over here on this end and then plug up the low pressure line. That way I can fill the solvent up. It's gonna fill up the whole line and then it's gonna empty out through this hose and it won't create a mess. I should have thought about that the first time doing it on the low pressure side, but I didn't think about it. Now I have like this huge mess that I have to clean up later. All right, so we'll go ahead and take the low pressure line here and then put that plug in, that red plug that I was using for the other thing in there. I'll probably have to hold that one because it's not really that tight. So next thing I need to do is just put the air in. Right, safety glasses on. Pretty much hold that one right there. Okay. Feel the fluid going through. Oh, I didn't open this fucking line. Oh, crap. Didn't think of that. Not holding the hose. Well, you wear safety glasses, kid. Oh, yeah, that thing. Too much pressure. All right. Should have had a two-man job, or at least if I should have kept that valve open, I would have not built up all that pressure. All right, make sure we got everything open. I cleaned it up a little bit better now. So now I know exactly what's wrong. So, yep. Let it flush through. We'll go with the third and final flush. Make sure everything goes out without a hitch this time. Fuck. Never without a hitch. Fuck. Damn it. Sprayed everywhere again. That's why you got safety glasses, kids. Fuck. All right, another cleanup.
Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this video on showing you how to flush that system. As you can see, that thing was a huge mess, especially since I was doing it by myself and I kept on forgetting to like open and close the valve and then plugging up the other valves and having those plugs keep on popping out on me and spraying everywhere. But luckily I didn't injure myself or have something bad happen. But definitely if you're doing this, make sure you have two hands or at least clamp that hose down into the bucket so that thing doesn't spray everywhere, because once that pressure builds up and it goes through that line, that thing just sprays out and you can't really stop it. Anyways, if you guys are working on your air conditioning and need more information and more details, check out my other videos on the expansion valve, doing the whole compressor and the whole charging system and everything. But on this video, I just wanted to show you the details on how to flush everything so that way you could take care of that piece and then work on the next piece as you go along. Anyways, if you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet to stay on top of all my different DIY videos, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching. I'll talk to you guys next time.